Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Diana, in Spanish. This is my first ever YouTube video. Sorry if my eyes look crazy. I have my phone tilted. So like I want to look straight and I am looking straight, but the camera's over here. So if I look a little, don't mind. But anyway, so today I'm going to be showing you guys my quick wash and go routine. Because honestly, I'm just lazy. I'm just lazy, and this is my quick wash and go when I want to just get moving, or if I have errands to run, or if I'm doing my hair before work, whatever the case might be. Okay, so that was enough talking. I'm just going to show you step by step. So first, I like to start off with like Jamaican castor oil. So this one right here, hope you guys can see that. Yeah, the coconut one. You can get like the mango or whatever. I just like coconut, so I get it the coconut flavor. I mean the coconut flavor. I still love coconut so much. The coconut, what am I trying to say? Coconut scent. So what I first do is I put it in this little bottle thing with the little peak, so I can massage my hair. Okay. Next, I'm going to just part it in different sections. Sometimes it depends how I'm doing my hair. Like, if I'm gonna have a part in the middle, I kind of part it in fours this way. If I'm gonna have a part on the side, I kind of just start from the bottom here. I'm gonna part it in the middle here. My part's probably gonna come out a little crooked because I'm not. Came out pretty darn good. Okay, I like to detangle first. And today I'm going to be reviewing the main choice here. What is it called? The Tropical Moringa. So let's see. Yeah, it smells pretty good. I also like to make sure I just get it in the roots here, because sometimes these little back hairs tend to irk. So then I want to do the comb one more time. Then we're gonna move on to the ceiling cream. Hopefully you guys can see that well. The ceiling cream, same scent. And obviously just eye your portions depending on the portion of hair you're going to be styling. And now the leaning brush. Sometimes I use this brush, sometimes I don't. Just depends. My hair can get really defined without it. But I'll just use it here now. So the more hair you comb, when it dries, the more you're gonna have to separate your curls. So if you wanna do small portions, as I said, I'm usually lazy and I just do all of that after. And if I feel like they're coming out two stuck together, then I just run my fingers through it and do it one more time. So I'm just gonna keep parting the sections here. The rest of my hair. You always want to detangle from the bottom up. That was something like my grandma used to tell me when she used to do my hair. This right here. I have to take the cap off because I really don't have time for this. Usually in this part, I take my glasses off because, yeah, they can get dirty and all that, so I'll do that. Actually, I can't even see myself on the screen if you ask me, so yeah. Make sure you get those ends. You see how my ends are like nasty looking? Make sure you guys put a lot of product on your ends here, so you don't wanna have your roots moisturized and then your ends look like crap. That's what we don't wanna do. And I apologize if I don't have any makeup on. I wasn't gonna put on makeup to take it off right after. So 95% of my videos will be without makeup, so just a heads up. All right. And as I said, it just depends. Honestly, if I don't have time to brush my hair out like this,
I don't.
So it's not like it's a must thing for me. Let me put my glasses back on. And as I'm doing this, I will kind of bring them together here in the back, so that line I mentioned earlier doesn't get stuck in the middle. Try to put leave-in conditioner and oil in my hair when I style it. Like, I can't see anything right now. I cannot see a thing. Just bear with me, guys. Just okay, so this is how my hair is looking so far. Last thing I like to do before I dry it, if I air dry or diffuse it, doesn't matter. What I like to do is I like to use this Girl's Daughter, the hair honey. Try not to put too much of it, because if you put too much of it, then your hair will get like really crunchy and it's just gonna feel like you have only gel on. So this is what I usually do. I kind of just form it through like this. I try to put more where my hair is dry the most, so in the middle, as I keep saying here. Scrunch, scrunch, scrunch. Damn, look at that bald spot. I like to massage it here in the middle because I don't want any lines from my parting left. So now I'm going to diffuse and you guys will see the final results. So here you go, guys. These are my final results. So this is my quick routine. Let me know what you guys think, what you would like to see in my next video. I'm uploading every Thursday because, you know, you're getting ready for the weekend, maybe to go out. And for me, in my case, my best hair days are like my wash and goes, but like the third and fourth day, actually, not even the second day, like the third and fourth, it gets really puffy and then I can kind of play with it more. So that's why I decided to upload a new video every Thursday. I also want to do a Spanish video for you guys, whether it's speaking in Spanish or just putting the subtitles in when I'm speaking English or whatever the case might be. So let me know if that's something you guys are interested in, because this channel is going to be bilingual. Any questions you guys have, leave them down below in the comments, and I'll try to get to them as quick as I can. So yeah, this is it. Thanks for watching, guys, and if you stuck around this far, thank you for watching my first video to the fullest.